Now that the iPhone has USB-C, not only can you podcast with a single cable, just your iPhone and the Riverside app, but you can actually connect full audio interfaces to connect XLR mics or even multiple microphones to your iPhone and podcast with remote guests using the Riverside app. I'm going to show you how to connect an audio interface like the Focusrite Vocaster 2 to your iPhone, and even how to use something like a Mixpre 3, which will record your in-person guest to an SD card and your remote guest in the Riverside app. The first thing you'll want to do is download the Riverside app for your iPhone or also on your iPad. With the app, you can enter your studio, use your iPhone as a 4K camera. Once you log in with your Riverside account, you can enter one of your studios, use your iPhone as a 4K camera to record a video podcast, and then connect your audio interfaces or microphones to record with remote guests. Now, some audio interfaces will actually require an additional power supply in order to work with the iPhone, and I'll show you that in a moment. But audio interfaces like the Vocaster 2 can actually plug directly into the iPhone, no hub or other power source required, and it'll work. I'm connecting the Focusrite Vocaster 2 with a USB-C cable to the iPhone, and you'll see the iPhone even has enough power to turn on the Vocaster 2. Now we can connect a Shure MV7 XLR microphone with a stylish Riverside windscreen, and you'll see our Vocaster 2 is getting audio signal from the microphone. Now once we join the studio from the iPhone Riverside app, now with an audio interface connected or a USB mic, you should see this window pop up. When you see it, tap No. Tapping No means you're going to use the same audio device for your input and output through the iPhone. The last thing you'll need to do is plug in a pair of wired headphones into the host or the guest if you have two people in person, and through that pair of headphones you'll hear your remote guests through the Riverside app. And here I am recording with an XLR microphone into an audio interface connected directly to my iPhone, doing a video podcast in 4K with the Riverside app. Now, one thing to keep in mind is when you use an audio interface with Riverside, all of the channels that are going into that interface will be recorded in one audio track in Riverside. So you won't get those separate tracks from your in-person guests like you normally do with remote guests. But this setup is still helpful if you want to record with an XLR microphone and your iPhone. But let's say you do want to have individual audio tracks for the people you're recording in person with and your remote guests through Riverside. Well, you can do that too. Some audio interfaces, like the Mixpre 3, can actually record multiple XLR microphones, and they can record to an SD card, sometimes a micro SD card. The Mixpre 3 is a great option, but there are other good options like the Zoom H4. We'll put links to several down in the video description where you can record locally to an SD card and connect it to your iPhone as an audio interface. Now, an interface like the Mixpre 3 requires a little more power than the iPhone can deliver. So in order to use an interface like that, and if you want to make sure your iPhone just stays charged as you're recording, you're going to need a USB-C hub. This is an Anker USB-C hub. We'll put a link in the video description, but this will allow us to plug in power to the iPhone and connect the audio interface. Now that we've plugged it into power, you can see my iPhone is charging, so we don't have to worry about the battery anymore. Then I'll take the other USB-C port from this hub, plug it into the USB-C port on the Mixpre 3, and it should turn on. Now I've plugged my Shure MV7 into the audio interface, and I'm going to plug a second microphone, the Audio-Technica ATR2100X. It can be used as a USB microphone or XLR. And now we have two channels connected to the Mixpre 3, and I can record these to the local SD card and also use the Riverside app to record with remote guests. Now that everything's connected, I'm going to enter my studio in the iPhone app. Again, you'll see that pop up if you're connected to the audio interface. Now that I have two microphones recording in-person guests, I can invite another remote guest. I can just send this link via text, email, and all they have to do is open that on their laptop and open it in the Chrome or Edge browser, or they can download the Riverside app too. And now I can start recording with two in-person guests and a remote guest, and both microphones are recording to the iPhone through the audio interface. And then to record my in-person guests on separate tracks, I can hit the record button here on my Mixpre 3, and this will now record both channels to the local SD card. I'll still get a combined audio track of those two in-person guests here in my Riverside recording, but then I can import those audio tracks from the SD card and I have separate audio for everyone that was in the recording. And with all the audio tracks recorded in Riverside, you can download those separate tracks from your remote guests. So that's how to connect an audio interface to your new iPhone 15, works with both a regular 15 and 15 Pro, and you can record with multiple in-person and remote guests using the Riverside app. If you'd like to learn more or have any questions, leave a comment below this video. I answer all of those personally. And subscribe to the Riverside channel because we have some exciting features coming very soon. I can't tell you about it, but they're very cool. And they're going to help make your content creation process, whether it's video or audio-only content, even faster. Thanks for tuning in. And before you go, if you want to learn more about podcast apps and what your podcast looks like in every platform, check out this video above. And if you're looking to start a podcast but you don't know where to begin, I have a video right here walking you through step-by-step how to do it. And you can check it out there. Thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you next time.